In the farthest reaches of the solar system, way past Neptune and Pluto, the planet 9 may be lurking. It's predicted to have a mass 5 times that of the Earth and revolves around the Sun once every 10,000 years on a highly elliptical, inclined orbit. But why do some scientists suspect that such a strange object exists? A hidden giant, a mysterious ninth planet lurking in the icy darkness far beyond Neptune. A world so distant, so faint, it eludes us for centuries. But what if it's real? And what if its gravitational whispers are shaping the very edge of our solar system? Hey everyone, welcome back to PhysxX Space, and today we'll explore the latest evidence from multiple groundbreaking studies. The ingenious ways scientists are searching, the tantalizing clues, the frustrating dead ends, and the burning question, is there really a strange new object in our solar system? Why are we even talking about Planet 9? What kicked off this whole cosmic chase in the first place? It all started with some serious weird behavior from a bunch of icy objects way out beyond Neptune, called extreme trans-Neptunian objects, TNOs for short. Imagine a handful of these distant space rocks. You'd think their orbits would be all over the place, right? But no, a whole bunch of them are tilted in a similar way. And their orbits all point in roughly the same direction. It's like they're all marching in a cosmic parade. Super weird. The scientists who study this, like Brown, Holman, and Badgin in 2024 paper, say this strange clustering is the best explained by a massive hidden planet pulling the strings. Now, you might be thinking, could this be just a coincidence? Well, astronomers crunched the numbers, and the chance of happening randomly are incredibly tiny, like almost zero. So what's the deal? The leading idea is that our mystery planet 9 is out there, acting like a gravitational Sifford. Its massive gravity, even from super far away, is gently tugging on these TNOs over millions and millions of years, slowly lining them up. This strange alignment was the first big breadcrumb that got everyone saying, maybe there is something else out there. So there is a strong hint, but if Planet 9 is so far away, it's practically invisible, reflecting hardly any sunlight. How on earth would you find this ghost planet? This is where things get clever. A team led by Fan in a 2025 paper had a brilliant idea. Forget reflected sunlight. Let's look for its heat. Think about it. Even if Planet 9 is freezing cold, it should still have some leftover heat from when it was formed, or from natural processes inside it. This heat would radiate out as infrared light, a faint heat signature, so they dug into the whole data from two space telescopes that could see infrared light. IRIS, which scanned the sky in 1983, and Akari, which did its thing around 2006 and 2007. Why infrared? Well, sunlight gets super weak the further you go out. But a planet's own internal heat doesn't fade nearly as much when you're trying to spot it from afar. So weirdly enough, Planet 9 could actually look brighter in infrared than in normal light. The really smart part was comparing the IRIS data from the 83 with the Akari data from 23 years later. If a little warm spot seen by IRIS had moved by the time Akari looked, there's a massive clue. It's not the same distant star, but something much closer, orbiting our sun. Bingo, maybe Planet 9. An infrared moving target. Sounds promising, right? So, did Fan's team hit the jackpot? Did they actually find Planet 9's heat signature? You bet, they found something exciting. After digging through tons of data, they spotted one really good candidate. In their paper, they said they found an IRIS source, a warm blip from 1983, that was gone from the exact spot in the Akari images 23 years later. And this is the cool part. A new warm blip, looking very similar, had popped up nearby in the Akari data. That's exactly what we'd expect from a slow-moving distant planet. This is super tantalizing. It's the kind of signal that makes planet hunters jump up and down, but hold your horses. Good science means being careful. Fan and his team say these two sightings, while awesome, aren't quite enough to nail down the planet's full orbit or be 100% sure it's Planet 9. They need more observations to confirm it's a real planet on a stable path, not some weird cosmic coincidence. So it's not a hot lead, but the next step is crucial. Point more telescopes at that exact spot and see if it's still out there and still moving like a planet should. Looking for the heat is one part, but what about the old school method? Have scientists tried using powerful optical telescopes, the kind that see normal light, to just scan the heavens for a faint moving dot? Absolutely. A huge search was done by Brown, Holman, and Badgin, written up in a 2024 paper. They used a mountain of data from the Pan-STARRS-1 survey in Hawaii. This planet basically photographed about 3/4 of the entire sky over and over for the 5 years. But they weren't looking for heat, they were hunting for that incredibly faint speck of reflected sunlight from Planet 9. Can you imagine the challenge? They started with something like 1.26 billion potential tiny dots of light from just one night. Most of them is just noise or tiny asteroids. Their job was to use super smart computer programs to sift through all that, looking for just a handful of faint specks seen on different nights over several years that could be linked together to show a planet-like orbit. It's like the universe's hardest game of connect the dots. A billion dots filtered down. Wow. So after all that, did the giant pan-STARRS survey finally spot Planet 9? Well, the results were fascinating, but maybe not the eureka moment everyone hoped for. The pan-STARRS survey, even when combined with other big sky scans like ZTF, DES, did not find a clear Planet 9 that matched what scientists thought it would look like based on earlier predictions. In fact, they concluded that about 78% of the most likely hiding spots and brightness levels for Planet 9 have now been searched, and it has not shown up in those places. Now, this does not mean Planet 9 is a goner. What it tells us is that if it's still out there, it's probably not where we mostly thought it was, or it's fainter than we expected. This is super useful information because it helps us narrow down the search. Maybe Planet 9 is even dimmer, or it's hiding in a really tricky part of the sky to see, like in the super crowded plane of our Milky Way galaxy, or in the parts of the southern sky that haven't been scanned as deeply yet. The hunt gets tougher, but also more focused. We have talked heat, we have talked light, but are there any other, maybe more of the world clues that could point us to the Planet 9? You're gonna love this one. A paper by Socrates Navarro Trillo in 2025 had a serious cool idea. Back in 2014, a small rock from another star system, an interstellar meteoroid called CNEOS-14, burned up in the Earth's atmosphere. Their wild idea: what if, on its way through the outer solar system, this little space traveler got a gravitational nudge from Planet 9, which sent it catering towards Earth? Even crazier, the direction it seemed to come from was pretty close to where some theories predicted Planet 9 might be. They call this the messenger hypothesis. The meteoroid acted like a cosmic informant. So this scientist aimed their telescopes at the exact patch of the sky where Planet 9 should be if it was the one that flicked CNEOS-14 our way. They looked for anything in that spot that showed a tiny shift in position from one night to the other. That shift, called parallax, is what you see if an object is relatively close compared to the super distant background stars, because Earth itself is moving in its orbit. A meteor from another star pointing the way to the Planet 9. That's movie stuff. So did the super targeted clever search actually lead them to the hidden planet? Unfortunately, despite their careful search of the specific area, Socrates, Navarro, and Trillo had to report no credible Planet 9 candidates were identified within this field and magnitude limits. Basically, they did not find anything that looked like a Planet 9 there, and at least not down to how faint their telescopes could see, which was about magnitude 21.3. Pretty faint. So what gives? Well, it could mean a few things. Maybe Planet 9 isn't in that particular spot, or the whole meteorite messenger idea, while cool, might not have been accurate for that location. And this is a theme, isn't it? Planet 9 might be even fainter than they could detect. So another piece of the puzzle telling us where Planet 9 isn't, or at least how sneaky it might be. Okay, so the plot thickens, but hold on, because the story isn't over. Is there another totally different group of objects out there that might be giving us a fresh clues about Planet 9? You bet there is. And this is hot off the press from April 2024. A paper by Bertin, Morbidelli, and Brown, him again, and Norsverny looked at a group of objects called long-period trans-Neptunian objects that have fairly faint orbits, but, and this is the key, they cross Neptune's orbit. These aren't the same as those super-distance TNOs. They found 17 of these Neptune crossers, and guess what? The way their orbits are spread out, especially how close they get to the Sun, is really hard to explain if Planet 9 isn't out there pulling some strings. Why are these guys so important? Well, objects that cross Neptune's orbit does not last very long, astronomically speaking. Neptune's gravity tends to mess them up pretty quickly, so if we see a bunch of them now, they must be getting constantly refilled from somewhere farther out. And that's where Planet 9 comes in. The scientists ran a ton of super detailed computer simulations. They found that if Planet 9 exists, its gravity naturally nudges objects from way out in the solar system into those Neptune crossing orbits, perfectly explaining the population we see. But here's the kicker. When they ran simulations without Planet 9, the model just didn't match what we observe. Not even close. In fact, the no Planet 9 model was rejected with super high confidence. Something called 5 sigma, which in science means it's almost certainly wrong. This is a brand new, really strong piece of the evidence for Planet 9 coming from a completely different angle. Wow. Okay, my head is spinning with all these clues. We've caught the original weird TNOs orbit, that tantalizing infrared candidate, the huge sky scans that have narrowed the search, that meteor clue, and now this really strong new evidence from the Neptune crossers. So if we put all this together, what's the current score in the hunt for Planet 9? Are we getting any closer? It's like a giant cosmic puzzle, and we're definitely fitting more pieces together. That infrared blip from Fan's team gives us a specific target to check out. The big optical surveys by Brown and others, while not finding Planet 9 where they first looked, have told us it's likely fainter or hiding in tougher spots. The meteoroid search by SOCAS, Novaro, Twilo cleared other small areas, and now this Neptune crosser study from Badgin's team gives a fresh, really powerful statistical thumbs up for the Planet 9's existence. What does this all mean? Well, for a lot of astronomers, the idea that something big is out there is looking stronger than ever. When a search comes up empty, it's not a failure. It actually helps scientists refine their ideas about where Planet 9 might be and what it might be like. But when you get positive hints like the infrared candidates and especially strong statistical arguments like the one from the Neptune crossers, it really boosts the case. It's like having multiple witnesses in a detective story, all pointing towards the same suspect. The evidence is building. This is also exciting. So final big, what's next? Are we on the verge of actually finding Planet 9, or is it going to keep playing hide and seek forever? Get ready, because the hunt is about to go overdrive. All the scientists are saying the same thing. We need more data and better data. The infrared candidate need to be checked out ASAP. And everyone is pointing to a new telescope being built in Chile called the Vera Rubin Observatory. Brown, Holman, Badgin say it will be able to see almost all the predicted hiding spots for Planet 9, even if it's super faint. And even better, Badgin's team with their SWIM Neptune crosser study have made specific predictions about what Vera Rubin should find and if Planet 9 is real, clear tests we can do very soon. Why is Vera Rubin such a big deal? This telescope is going to be a beast. It will scan huge chunks of the night sky, deeper and fainter than ever before, over and over for 10 years. It's expected to find millions of new things in our solar system. If Planet 9 is out there, Vera Rubin has a fantastic chance of spotting it. And those predictions about Neptune crossers, Vera Rubin is perfectly built to see if they hold up. Finding Planet 9 wouldn't just be cool because we found a new planet. It would tell us so much about how our solar system was born and grew up. The chase is on, and it feels like we're closer than ever. So is Planet 9 out there? We don't have a yes or no stamp on it just yet. But you have seen the clues piling up. And they're pretty darn compelling, from those weirdly aligned TNOs to that possible heat signature. From the massive sky searchers that are zeroing in on its hiding place, to that powerful new evidence from Neptune crossers. It's a fantastic scientific detective story unfolding right before our eyes. And with amazing new tools like Vera Rubin Observatory coming up online soon, the next few years could be absolutely revolutionary. Imagine being the one to finally spot a brand new giant planet in our own backyard. What do you think? Is Planet 9 waiting to be discovered? I'd love to hear your theories down in the comments. And hey, if you want to dive deeper, I'll put the links of these actual research papers in the description below. You can check out the science for yourself. Thanks so much for joining me in this cosmic adventure. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and ring that notification bell so you don't miss our next trip into the unknown. Until then, keep looking up and keep asking questions. Thanks for watching.